to a series of lessons for my level 3 portfolio. So we're going to be doing 4 lessons and then a club fitting. So we're going to be doing some swing analysis, swing mechanics, short game, putting, on-course lesson, and then we're going to fit you for some clubs through new Mizunos. Better by fitting it for the club. First, if we could just take a couple shots and I can assess your swing, we can see what we need to improve. What club do we have in our hands right now?
This is pitching wedge.
Pitching wedge? Alright, is that your go-to club once you get to the range? Just first club out of your bag. Is that your pitching wedge?
Probably gap wedge, probably 52.
52?
That's all that matters.
Alright. We'll start with the 52. A couple shots at that 52. Alright, so when you are ready for your next round, what are we gonna do when we're at the range? How are we gonna warm up and get ready for our next round? Using the information we learned today.
I'd say maybe start with maybe that little half
back, half
forward, try and get that point of contact pretty accurate. Possible
at least. The three to nine swing, as I call it, or the 50-50, that's good for impact. Well, would you ever kind of use that pool noodle in the future?
Yeah, I would. It's a good point, especially because that's what I do anyway. Like, in play, I'm picking a spot, whether it's a leaf or stick in front of the ball.
The range, though, when you're not playing, I do recommend that you could play like 2 or 3 holes in your head. Mentally imagine that we're playing a quick 2 holes. We'll hit driver, and then based upon the results of our shot, we can hit whatever club we want. So if we're thinking that that par 4, number 1, if we hit it a little bit to the right, we know that we have some tree trouble, and maybe we'll try to hit a knockdown shot. If we hit it right down the middle, we could hit a nice 75-yard wedge into the green.
Definitely.
If we don't hit that green flag out there, then we'll basically realize that we didn't hit the green, and we're going to be trying to save par. Other than that, you did great. You had a good time out there.
Okay, thanks, Jeff.
Yeah.
Hey, you.
Good job.
Thank you.
How's it going, Alex?
Jeff, good to see you today.
Good to see you too. Thank you for doing the second lesson.
You got it.
We're going to be doing putting. So first, we're going to take a couple putts. We're going to be doing roughly 4 to 6 putts. Okay, so we got a couple drills and a couple training aids. We got the putting arc that you can grab in the pro shop anytime, and that'll work on stroke. Also, we have the drills that we can do from roughly 3, 6, 9, 10, 15, however you want to set it up. You can do 3 putts from each, or you can make a little game out of it. If you miss one,
decrease
the balls going down, kind of pressurize the situation and make it fun in the process.
Right.
This is a great lesson. We'll see you on Thursday night. All right. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
How's it going, Alex?
Yeah, it's good to see you again.
Nice to see you again. Thanks for doing the short game video with me now.
Oh, absolutely. Pleasure.
So first, what we're going to basically do is just start off with a couple of pitches. I'm just going to assess and observe your shots. See where your ball position is, where your setup is, any areas of improvement we'd like to start on, and then I'll get your type of strategy that you go through with your short game shots, figure out what you'd like to work on, what you'd like to improve, and I have some little drills we can do around the short game area that I already set up. Alright, so if you could just start hitting some pitches to the red flag. I got some cones out there. Alright, Alex, so we worked on about three different things today. One, we worked on the specialty shot with the lob shot from we have a little green to work with. We worked on the bump and run, and we also worked on some chipping as well and pitching. So the bump and run, it makes us kind of give ourselves more clubs to work with when we're around the green, pitching. Kind of get ourselves to know exactly how far we need to take it back in terms of distance control. And a little bit better setup. So overall, you did well. There's some areas you need to work on in terms of setup. And just the things we used today, we used the pool floating. This roughly cost $2. And then we had the alignment stick, which I cut in half. That cost another dollar, so $3 plus Uncle Sam. And you can have this in your car, set it up at the short game area. And there's so many different things you can use it for. You can use it with chipping, trying to keep it under it. You can use it with pitching, trying to get it over. Just stab it on the sides, and then stab it into the ground.
And as well with a lob shot,
if we have a pin that's not in the area we want it to be in, we can drill this down in the ground, and it can act as a pin. And it can just be more visible. And also with the cones that we set up on the short game area in terms of getting us to basically mentally imagine our shots and where we want to land it.
So yeah,
a bunch of different cones, and that's roughly $5. So there's a lot of things that you can grab in terms of doing training aids and drills in order to be better with the short game. I think we improved a lot of aspects. What do you think is the most important thing that you learned today out of the three activities that we went through?
I'd say definitely that'll benefit my game the most would probably be the bump and run. I never really, obviously known about it, but never really utilized it as much as I maybe should, because I think the biggest thing for that is limiting the margin of error, because there's a lot of shots that, you can chip and you can miss and chunk. You do this, put yourself in a position to make higher numbers. You really don't have to. You can put a lot of pump to be pretty accurate as you showed today. So it's good to have more weapons in your bag as you have said before.
Absolutely.
All weapons are better.
You have 14 clubs in your bag. You might as well not narrow it down for two and try to use almost all of them.
Definitely.
We can also just use course knowledge with the topography of the green and treat it just like a putt. And that'll give us a better chance of par. Heck, we can even pull out for birdie like we did one with the pitch and one with the bump and run, which was great. All right, thank you for your time.
Thank
I'll
you
see you
for
in
your
next
time.
Lesson.
Sounds good.
All right, Alex, thanks for showing up to the on-course portion of our lesson.
Of course. Excited.
Yeah, I'm excited too. So we're on the second hole at Clinton Country Club. It's 444 yards from the black tees. So it's a 3 handicap hole.